different defensively recently here?
I think just the energy. I think the talk. I don't know if the players would agree, but I think this is a communication of connection through timeouts on the floor. There's not any bickering or, you know, indecision. They're covering each other. They're playing for each other, which is kind of cool to watch.
How would you describe Porzingis' performance, especially on defense?
Oh, he was great. He was great from the start. On the defensive end, he was great on the help, protecting the rim. Offensively, I thought, again, letting the game come to him, letting the ball find him. He was great. I thought the bench, the energy from the voices over there when before even the game started, you could hear guys into the game. And so on a back-to-back, it's easy to have that built-in excuse against a very talented offensive team. And I thought the guys did a great job.
Dwight played 8 minutes. Was it just very clear early on that this was matchup-wise, that one big lineup were going to make sense in this game?
Yeah, I think small ball, they're one of the best. When you look at Golden State and Charlotte, they play small ball at a very, very high level. And so DP did a great job. It was nothing that he didn't do anything wrong. Looking at Maxey, KP, and Moses didn't play a lot of minutes tonight either. But the matchups, you know, for us, with KP and Maxey on the floor is something that we feel comfortable with. Again, that second unit was great. Trey was at an all-time high for us, running the show, finding guys, and then also taking shots that when they presented themselves. But I thought our pace in attacking the paint was, again, high tonight, too.
You've got your game face on, you know, 48 minutes pretty much. But what goes through your head when you fans start chanting Golfon's name?
Yeah, you know, they paid money to express themselves. Hopefully they got what they wanted. They got the W. They got Boban. Santa Claus, whatever else they want. It's the Christmas holiday season. And Boban didn't disappoint.
All right, one more on that note. Eddie, who has a similar color palette.
Two. It's Christmas season.
A couple things, Jason. First, with Luka out, how gratifying is it to see guys actually take that bull by the horns and step up, like guys like Trey and Josh and Moses too, but especially Trey tonight? And also, do you have any clues about whether Luka might be back Wednesday?
To answer the first part, I think it's great. You know, those guys have pride and they have, you know, they have egos too. And I thought that group, you know, they've been moving the ball. You know, it started last night. It was a carryover tonight. Everyone's touching it. There is no, like, you know, waiting to see if someone's just going to dribble and shoot. It's just a matter of trusting the paint touch or attacking or being unselfish, and you can see that with the way the ball is moving. The second part of that question, we'll give you an update game time on Wednesday.
Trey, this is y'all's fifth game in 7 nights. How much talk was there before the game about, you know, kind of the need to push through that?
A lot of energy talk tonight. We know that they had a couple days off. I think they played 2-3 days ago, and we just played last night. So that's usually not a good combination. But for us, we wanted to come out with energy and set the tone. And first unit did a great job of that. Second unit was ready to come in and play.
Does the preseason game factor in at all? Like, do you guys think about that at all?
I did personally, but no one on the team talked about it. During the game, I personally thought about that. You know, I figured that they would have this game marked.
Right.
So, you know, I tried to continue to let them know, you know, we can't come out flat like we usually do and try to, you know, regain the lead here in the third or fourth quarter. You know, it's a scary team, a team with a lot of talent. They play free. I think we did a great job of setting the tone early on. This should be one of our, like, prototype games, just to as far as how we come out and, you know, the energy that we come out with, because that's been an issue of ours, not only this year, last year as well. We got to come out with the energy we did tonight, and we give ourselves a chance every night, I feel like.
We talk a lot about shooting the past few, honestly, weeks at this point. How's it feel to actually see shots go down, just team-wide even?
It felt good, man. Felt like Mavs basketball, you know. That's how I've been since I've been here the last three, you know, the last couple of years, and you know, it felt good to come out hot. You know, the ball was moving, everybody touching the ball. I think KP came on and set, you know, and set the momentum, and we just took it from there.
What do you think has been the difference for you guys defensively recently here?
I think when the ball moves on offense, it kind of trickle down to our defense, and guys kind of play with more energy. You know, I think that's what it was today. We came out, you know, we guarded, you know, the first two quarters real good, even though we didn't finish the second half how we wanted to, but, you know, we put ourselves in a good position to win the game.
Not to put a bad or uncomfortable spin on it, but you realize it's been nearly a month since you guys won at home.
The greatest part is we always been a good road team, but yeah, we got to change that, man. We got to protect the house, you know, starting now, we can just move forward and try to get some wins home, you know, but you know, over the last couple of years, we've been a better road team anyway, so.
Back to the defense, you've been here quite a few years, you played with quite a few centers. No knock on any of them, but when you have someone like KP, is there an extra level of confidence when KP is affecting shots at the rim like he did tonight and mostly in the season?
When he playing with a lot of energy, you know, KP is probably one of the, you know, he's top three in block shots, you know, whenever he active and whenever he moving, and you see in the night, you know, I feel like he was contesting every shot. Even though if he didn't get the block, he was definitely making them change their shots. Or when they went in the paint, they was not even trying to shoot. They were getting stuck in the air because he's so long. But I think we did a good job of helping each other. Just try to take from this game and learn from it. You know, you can learn from wins, too.
Does anything change with your approach as a man defender on the perimeter, with just knowing that he's back there?
No, I still try to play defense knowing I ain't got no help. But, you know, it feels good, you know, knowing that you got teammates behind you. You know, basically just talking to you, telling you, you know, I got low man, I'm behind you. So, you know, you could be a little bit more extra aggression on defense.
Okay, we'll do one more, and then Coach will be here. Kevin, go ahead.
And Dorian, did you realize that that third quarter was your highest scoring third quarter, or your highest scoring quarter in your career with those 13 points tonight?
No, I just was playing, man. The ball was just finding me, and I didn't get many looks first half, but you know, that's part of the game. You know, I don't really care about shots, and the ball was moving, and eventually it's gonna find you. If you play basketball with the right intentions, you know, I feel like the ball always gonna find you.
You guys were playing your fifth game in 7 days, but it didn't look like it from your effort. How difficult is it to dig deep like that and come out strong?
I think it's just having that mentality. We knew we had to come out, especially against this team. We knew that they were going to try to throw the first blow after we played them in preseason. So I think we just did a great job of staying ready, staying poised, being aggressive, and not letting up on the gas, even though we had a game yesterday.
I know all we've been talking about lately is the shooting. How's it feel making shots?
Feels amazing. That's all I can say.
And do you feel like quality of shots was particularly good tonight, or the result was just better?
I mean, just the results were better, I guess. I mean, when you're a shooter and you see a lot of your shots going in and out, hitting back rim, you're getting clean ones, leaving your hands good, and you're not seeing the result at the end, can't really do much about it. So I just continue to work, just continue to put the hours in the gym like I normally do, and hopefully the result will come out as a positive.
You know, people talk about, you know, JK's talked a lot about when you don't make shots, tendency to hang the head. What's the, is there a reverse effect when you are getting stops that kind of fuels offense and suddenly the basket looks bigger?
Well, that definitely helps. Getting stops and being able to run. As Indiana, I didn't knock down any of my threes, I feel like. But when we were getting stops and running the break and getting easy looks and getting driver lanes, that's what makes it fun and takes your mind off it a little bit. So as long as you continue to get stops, get rebounds, push the ball, and get easy looks, you should be fine.
The fact that you had the game that you had tonight with all the energy running around, and the fact that it was the second game on back-to-back, you know, given the last few years, everything you've built up, what does it mean to you?
It's weird, but I almost feel better on the second game of back-to-back than when I have to get my body going for the first one. It's weird, yeah, but I felt good. I mean, obviously some games are like physically more taxing. Yesterday wasn't one of those games, you know. But I felt better today than I did yesterday in a weird way. My body kind of, once it gets going, I just need to keep it up even on off days. I always try to get some work in so I stay moving and I don't get, you know, I'm still young, but some days I'm like, oh man, like the body just gets a little, you know, rusty. So, I gotta keep working.
What does it feel like team-wide for shots to go down? Just because that's the thing we keep talking about. Mm-hmm. It feels like every single time you're up there, we're asking, what's wrong with the shooting? So this time they're actually going around. Like, what's the feeling team-wide?
No, it was a good night for us. We started off shooting really well, and it kind of carried over, you know, to everybody. Then, you know, Trey came in, gave us a great spark on offense. And we're just playing free out there, playing really free. And you know, even the games we haven't been great offensively, it's mostly because we're not just making shots, you know, and then kind of carries over, our energy carries over to the defensive end. But tonight it was there on both ends, and you could see the result.
Miles Bridges has put a lot of guys on posters in this league. What do you think when that was a pretty aggressive attempt by him? What did you think when he went up there?
Yeah, for a half a second I was in the air and I was like, this could go really bad. But I was like, I'm already there, so just kinda, you know, saw that I didn't jump late. If I jumped late, then it would have been probably dunk of the year because I would have lifted him up. But I jumped a bit early before him. And I was able to get it there, but that was kind of, if you're on time, you have to jump, you know. As a shot blocker, sometimes you're gonna get dunked on, but you have to jump every time if you're there on time, and that's what I did, came out of that exchange lucky and got the block.
You know, you say if you're on time, you have to jump. Is that just kind of obligation to your teammates? Is it pride? Like,
I think as a shot blocker, you're just not gonna go. You know, you're not gonna give up anything easy. You know, if you're there, I'm a shot blocker for a reason, to protect the rim, and sometimes you're gonna get dunked on. It's just it is what it is. You're gonna be on some highlight reels, but it cannot stop you from jumping the next time. You know.
Usually it's Maxi, not you. It's a running joke we have with Maxi. He's always the one. Do you like just the same way that you have like on offense, like you have hot shooting nights? Do you prep games where you just feel like, oh man, I'm rotating well, I'm contesting well, or I guess the flip side is it's more about how they're dragging at you, but are there games where you just really feel like you're on it?
I think it starts kind of from our guards. If our guards are in them and kind of making it tough on the drive, then it gives also me it also gives me a little more time to go for the block, you know. And right. If it's a wide open drive, sometimes it's hard to get there, you know. Tonight everybody did a great job defensively and offensively. It was just kind of it was a fun game to be a part of, you know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we have one in Spanish, Leonardo.
KP, te saluda Leonardo Torres de Perú. Felicidades por la victoria. KP, a inicios de temporada mencionaste que buscabas estar a plenitud física. ¿Ya te encuentras a plenitud física y qué es lo que más te gustó del equipo esta noche? Gracias.
Buenas, sí, estoy Diría que estoy llegando a estar muy bien físicamente. Todavía me queda, todavía noto que hay partidos, hay situaciones en donde me gustaría estar con un poco más de chispa, pero vivo en la sala de pesas. Estoy trabajando mi cuerpo todo el rato y la verdad que con cada partido voy estando en mejor forma física. Y hoy sí, hoy ha sido un partido de disfrutar, un partido divertido y una victoria fácil.